Hello and good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this week's episode of Creative Corner. Today I have for you still life painting. So before we get into today's demonstration, let's go ahead and go over some of the materials we'll be using today. The materials that I have for today's session is I have some acrylic paint, a variety of paint brushes, some palette knives as well, a cup of water, and some backup brushes too as well. I also have some paper towels just to wipe off the paint brushes when I'm finished. And then right in front of me, I also do have a canvas panel that is 16 inches by 20 inches. And then on my left, your right hand side, I also have our still life set up. Going back to our previous video, which I'll go ahead and link in the description below, but you're more than welcome to utilize anything for your still life. Flowers, fruits, statues, anything you can get your hands on basically. And then you're gonna set up a nice composition, and then we'll go ahead and get into today's session. Compositionally speaking, we're gonna go ahead and map out everything onto our canvas panel first, and then we'll go ahead and start painting. So the technique that I usually like to do is I like to pretend that my pencil is against a flat surface, and then I'm gonna measure the angles of everything using the pencil. So like this box angle here, I'm gonna go ahead and measure it, make a little line, and that's my approximate start. I'm gonna do this for every single one of my lines. And it doesn't have to be perfect at the start, because we're going to clean it up afterwards. And I don't know if you can tell, but my lines is a little bit too high because my composition is going to be cut off towards the top. So what I want to do is go ahead and shift this down a little bit more. Alright, so this is going to be the rough composition of my overall still life. We'll go ahead and get started on painting. But before we go ahead and do that, we're going to go ahead and get rid of some of the lines that I made previously. before I shifted down the painting. So that'd be these darker lines toward the back of the painting. So let's go ahead and do that now. With this painting, I'm gonna go ahead and start off in the foreground, which is the bottom of the painting. Gonna add some orange so I can mimic the very bottom of this. And with this, you just want to make sure that you get the very base color of what you're working with. And you can always go lighter or darker depending on your actual painting. The color I'm using for this base orange is orange yellow. I like it because it's a little bit nice and vibrant compared to any other orange that I have. Like I said, I'm just trying to get the base color down. We're gonna keep working on this. I think my apple is a little bit too wide, but that's okay. Let's go ahead and add some orangish red or red orange to create a nice cast shadow. Thank you. Okay, so this blue I'm working with is Faux blue. It's a little bit darker than the sheet, but I think it'd be okay. Okay, so I added some yellow because I don't know if anyone's seen, but I have a yellow origami butterfly inside my still life. And I just want to add the base colors of everything I have. So right here I have a pear. So I have a green pear on one side of this fruit basket, and then right behind it I have a yellow pear. So I put my green down. I decided to go with yellow green. And then come back, add some yellow for the pear in the back. And then I also have a lemon. So I'm gonna add yellow for the lemon. Thank you. add some orange because I have an orange right behind this apple. Then I have a variety of grapes in the back. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab some violet. And just add some circles from my grapes. Then I'll go ahead and add some details to it later. Then I have another apple here, so add more red. Okay, now that I have most of my basic shapes, more of this phthalo blue. Carry on this background. So if you do this at home, I really would like it if you shared your final product. I'm not really great at still life, so we're learning this together. But if you, like I said, if you do this at home and you like what you've done, go ahead and put it into the comments below. Okay, I think this is all the time we have for, so. It's a very rough start to our still life, but we've included everything. We have the orange tablecloth. We also have the blue tablecloth. We have the yellow origami butterfly. We have two apples, an orange, a pear, actually two pears, one green, one yellow, lemon, some grapes, a flower vase with the flowers in it, and of course the fruit basket itself. And then I did a very rough Payne's gray background just to give it some nice texture compared to the white background how it was before. So again, if you have any paintings that you are doing or will do in the future that are still life based, go ahead and put them in the comments below or send it to us by any of our social media platforms. This is our still life painting, and we'll go ahead and do something fun and exciting for next time. Thank you very much, and you have a good rest of your day.